Now students, we are here with the question number 25. And according to this question, you just have to look at the schematic diagram. So the schematic diagram is given below, and in that you have to find out the incorrect statement. So let's have a look on the schematic diagram. First we have A, that is a particular substance. It is getting heated and ultimately it is getting changed into B and HCl vapors. It means it is getting changed into HCl vapor as well as the vapors of B. So these two substances are produced here. Further, A is heated with NaOH in the aqueous solution, and then we are getting C. Further, C is reacting with concentrated HCl. It is giving you D, and this substance D is shaken well with H2O to give another substance, that is E. It is an aqueous acidic solution. It means is question mein humko identify karna hai ki substance A kis tarah se B mein change ho raha hai ya wo kis tarah se C mein change ho raha hai, aur uske baad hume check karna hai ki kaun sa option correct hai. Let's have a look on the options. The first option is A and E are chemically same. Second option is A and D are chemically same. Further, we have the D and E are chemically same, and then we have C and E are chemically same. Students, in this particular reaction we can clearly see that a substance is A, which is first heated to give you B, and if it is cool, it is further changing into A. This is the property of ammonium chloride, and ammonium chloride is when heated it is giving you B, that is ammonia. Let's have a look on the second substance, that is C. A is getting changed into C in the presence of NaOH. It is again the property of ammonium chloride. NaOH to combine with ammonium chloride to form the substance ammonia again. Ammonia फिर से combine होगा concentrated HCl के साथ में, और दोबारा से हमें एक substance मिलेगा, वो होगा ammonium chloride. अब हम इसकी help से check करेंगे कि further ammonium chloride के साथ जब हम उसको water में dissolve करते हैं तो we are getting here aqueous acidic solution, क्योंकि ammonium chloride एक weak base और strong acid का salt है. It means this E is an aqueous acidic solution of ammonium chloride. Now let's have a look on the given options. First we have A and E are chemically same. Definitely students, A and E, A is ammonium chloride and E is again the aqueous acidic solution, that is again the ammonium chloride. So this statement is correct. It means we cannot say that this is the incorrect statement. Further we have A and D are chemically same. What is A? Ammonium chloride. What is D? Again ammonium chloride. This is dissolved in water. So both A and D are ammonium chloride. These are chemically same. So again this statement is also correct. Further we have D and E are chemically same. This D is ammonium chloride, that is given here, and E is the aqueous solution of ammonium chloride. These are chemically same, so this is also the correct statement. Now we have left with C and E are chemically same. What is C? C is ammonia and E is ammonium chloride solution. In this way, which statement is incorrect here? Definitely the statement C and E are chemically same is incorrect statement. So the option for this question that is correct here is option 4. That we can even mark here in the terms of answer, that is option 4. Now I hope student this question is clear to you. Now let's move towards the next question, that is the question number 26. Just have a look on this question. Which of the following is a feasible reaction? We have the four options given here, and all these options contain several chemical equations. We have to just identify which equation is feasible reaction. Let's check the first option, Ba combining with potassium sulfate to give you barium sulfate and potassium. Students, this type of question we solve with the help of reactivity series. And in the reactivity series, highly reactive metal can displace less reactive metal from its salt solution. So here we have barium in the solid state. It's reacting with potassium sulfate to give you barium sulfate and potassium. In this case, being less reactive, it cannot displace potassium. So this reaction is not feasible. Further, we have the next equation in which zinc is there. Zinc is reacting with silver nitrate solution. When zinc is added to this, it is forming zinc nitrate solution and silver is displaced here. It means we have to just check whether zinc is more reactive than silver or not. Definitely zinc is more reactive than silver. That is why it can displace the silver from silver nitrate. So this reaction is feasible. Further, we have magnesium reacting with sodium sulfate and giving you the displacement reaction, but magnesium is less reactive, it cannot displace sodium. So in that case, this reaction is not feasible. Further, we have copper that is displacing magnesium from magnesium sulfate, but according to the reactivity series, copper is less reactive. it cannot displace magnesium from magnesium sulfate. So humne dekha ki reactivity series humne yahan pe use kiya jisme more reactive metal less reactive metal ko displace karti hai aur uske basis pe hamara option 2 correct hai kyunki zinc is more reactive than silver. So let's mark the correct answer. The correct answer is option 2 and the answer for this question is option 2. I hope students, these questions are clear to you. Now let's move towards the next question.